All right, SMMA owners who are helping contractors, roofers, you name it. This is Michael Mignogna, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you a recorded Zoom call that I just did with a new client where I configure their business manager account. So you're going to actually get to watch every single thing I do to configure their Facebook business manager account, to make sure everything is set up perfectly, to make sure their accounts are secure, to make sure that they are aware of what's going on and how this works. And to make sure that both myself and my assistant have the access we need to their business manager to do all of the stuff we do when we set up and install our marketing system into their business. I think there's a lot to learn from this video, not just the buttons to press, but also how to talk about these things with your clients, how to answer certain questions, how to present things so that they're clear. This call is so important. It sets the whole mood for the rest of the relationship. So if you can get this call right and you can make it smooth and friendly and helpful and informative, maybe they learn a lot during the call. They should, at least if you do it properly. They're going to start off on a really good foot with you. They're going to love working with you just after having done this at a really high level. So I want you to watch it and I hope you get a ton of value from it. My phone's blowing up for some reason. Anyway, I hope you love this video. Leave a like and a comment below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And also make sure you check out the description of this video because I'll be putting in some helpful links, including a link to subscribe to my SMMA owner newsletter, where I will be sending out helpful information. I will be introducing videos there first. You know, any new content, those people that are subscribed will get alerted of that so that you can learn quickly. And any sort of courses and offers that I come up with to teach you more detail and about how exactly to do all of the things that I do, you'll be the first to know, and you'll have, you know, special offers through that newsletter. So that's it, guys. I hope you love this, and let's start the video. You know, today I want to accomplish two main things together. I want to get the access that I need to your Facebook Business Manager account so that I can, so that my assistant and I can build out all of the systems that we install into your business to generate leads and everything. But I also want to, you know, and I want to go over your service area and stuff like that. But I also want to talk about your services, brainstorm a little bit, learn a bit more, and then we'll be good to go. So let's start with you sharing your screen with me.
Okay.
By clicking the green share screen button at the bottom of your Zoom screen.
Got it.
And then choosing like desktop or, you know, like your whole computer basically to share. And then clicking share again in that window that has popped up.
Should I be sharing screen?
Yep. Perfect. Let's see how that looks. All right. Great. And then I'm going to request control of your mouse and you'll just accept it by clicking the accept button or whatever it says. Good.
Got it.
So now I'm able to open up a tab on your computer. And
nice.
Isn't that pretty cool? And yeah, I can go to facebook.com and it looks like you're logged in. And let's see who's logged in. So Jennifer's logged in here. Is that okay? Are we going to do this? What's that?
We're going to do it from mine. So we'll have to log into mine.
Okay, sure.
It doesn't matter. I mean, we both have control over the business. So it's right down there if you needed to scroll to it and get to it.
Well, you know what? Let's see if Jennifer does in fact have full access to the business that she would need to, like at a level that we need. So in order to figure that out, I'm going to go to business.facebook.com and it looks like Rainstorm Solutions. You know, if I click this, it looks like you do have a business account. That's great. And so this is the business manager and this is the business page. So that's great. It looks like this is so far set up, Jennifer has the right control. And so do you, it looks like.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. So that's great. So now if we go to business settings that'll actually open up the real business manager that where we can kind of administer all of your things and make sure all of the digital assets are organized in the right spot. So on this screen, I'm just kind of like doing an audit of the account. So you've got, you both have full access. That's awesome. Let's see if you have any partners working on your account. You don't have any partners working on your account. I'm eventually going to add my business as a partner with yours so I can access it that way as well.
No worries.
And then system users, that's fine. Pages. So your page is here. If it wasn't here, we would add it in, and it would most likely, as long as Jennifer has full access to the page, it would bring it in here automatically. But this is already there. Then we have an ad. So we don't have an ad account. So we're going to create an ad account. And then we're going to create a pixel. That's a tracking device.
Okay.
And then we are going to go into Security Center. We're going to make sure two-factor authentication is turned on because we don't want your account stolen, so that'll really keep it ultra secure. And right now there are so many Facebook scams happening, it's ridiculous, so I want to protect you from those.
I appreciate that. Yeah. Yeah.
And then it looks like you filled out the business info screen already, which is fantastic. If you have a tax ID, I'd recommend adding it in, like your EIN number. So I would,
yes, I do have an EIN number. She can do that. Yeah.
Okay, great. And then I would like to verify Jennifer's email address by putting in her email and having her verified. So let's go down the list and just start knocking these tasks out. So the first thing we're going to do is create an ad account, and I'm going to call it. So we're going to create a new ad account. And we're going to, it really doesn't really matter what you call it, but because this is not a public facing title that we're giving it, but obviously you want to call it something that is what your business is called. So Rainstorm Solutions LLC. And I like adding the words ad account to it just so it's easier to identify if you're looking at it in a list of digital assets and stuff like that. And where are you located again, Chris?
East Coast. I'm in Florida.
Right. All right. I remember now. Okay. So let's go to the right time zone. Isn't there a big storm heading your way again?
Yeah, it's going to loop off and hit Bermuda. Poor Bermuda.
They're going to get clobbered, aren't they?
They're going to get hammered, and it's going to be, they say, by a Category 4 by the time it gets around their way. So those are the scary ones. We just went through one last week, as a matter of fact, right before Labor Day.
Idalia, right?
Yeah.
It wasn't quite as bad as they had thought it would be. Thank God.
We had the other storm off the East Coast. It kept it from doing that hard right hand that it likes to do. It intensifies and causes a lot of damage when it does that. Yeah. It stayed down. It got to almost a Category 4 right as it hit land. Where it hit land at, they're totally devastated up there that area right now. Yeah. But it wasn't as widespread as some of the other ones had been. So we got lucky there, definitely. We're just south of there. And we were actually in the 75 plus mile an hour wind zone for about 6 hours that night. So it's
still not a walk in the park, that's for sure.
Oh man, I was up and down all night. It was howling like a freight train out there. My pool cage was shaking.
Mother Nature is amazing.
It's a beast.
Yeah. So we're going to choose my business for this, because it's actually your business, meaning. It's these ads are for your business. Click create, and that creates the ad account. And then what it's probably going to do right here is ask who wants, you know, who should have access to this account and what amount of access. So obviously you guys should have full access to all of your digital assets. Cool. So that's important. So you have full access to that. And then it's going to ask for payment info. This is not going to bill you anything. This is just going to put a card on file so that when your ads start running on Facebook, they have a way to charge you for them. So we'll put that in here right now. And actually, you can't even launch ads on Facebook unless you have a payment card on file. So
we've already got one on there. We've ran some boosted ads before. So
Yeah, you right. The thing is those boosted ads and that card you have on file for that is actually not in this business manager. It's part of your personal account. When you boost posts, yes. It's associated with your personal account, not your business account. So let's put this card on here.
Okay.
You can take over the mouse and do that.
Okay, there you go.
Done. Perfect. Okay. Awesome. So you've got an ad account there now. That's great.
Awesome.
Let's create
Thank
a
you.
Pixel. Yeah, you got it. So the Pixel is the tracking device that we use to basically, or I should say, essentially, you know, slip a tracking device in your website visitors' pockets and whenever they engage with any of your content. And then we can follow them around and sell them stuff. So we'll click continue. And we're going to click continue managing my business. And then we're going to add you guys to it with full access. And then we're also going to click add assets. And this associates the Pixel with your ad account. So it says basically for that ad account, you know, that's the Pixel that should communicate with it and everything. Let's go to, so now for the security center, you know, it's asking who in this business manager is required to turn on two-factor authentication. It's really important that it should say everyone. Okay. And that means that anyone that has access to this business manager has to have two-factor authentication turned on in order to have access. And that's going to really keep you safe from people hacking into your account and using your ad account and using your card on file to run ads in a different country or something like that. So, let's make sure we can do that. So I'm going to click Jennifer's profile picture here, and I'm going to click settings and privacy. And let's see if I can find where the two-factor is. They always change it. So, looks like privacy. Let's see, check a few important settings. It should be in here. How to keep your account secure. Turn on two-factor authentication. So here you go. So
there it is.
Continue, your password is fine. You can set blah, blah, blah. So get started. This should take us to the two-factor. Yep. So we're going to use text messages for two-factor.
Yep.
Is that Jennifer's cell phone?
It is. Yep.
Okay. Is she with you right now?
Hey, babe, I need you and your phone here real quick.
We just need that six-digit code that should have been texted to her.
Six-digit code that just got sent to your phone. Yes, ma'am.
Jennifer, thank you for knowing your passwords and being able to do that.
I don't know how much save them.
It's great. It's fantastic. Thank you. And
she's got a two-step code that she's got to hit a code before it lets her go into that too. So
yeah. So basically what this means is, Jennifer, if you go to like the public library and you want to log into your Facebook account on one of their computers and you go to log in, you put in your email and password, it's then going to say, we've just sent you a text message. You know, put that code in order to actually log into your Facebook. And that means if someone were to steal your email and your password, they still wouldn't be able to get into your Facebook account unless they also had your phone and they were able to unlock it and get the code that's sent.
Right on.
Okay.
Well, if they do get my information, I hope they pay some bills of ours.
Yeah, wouldn't that be nice? That would be a hilarious fraud scheme
not on our credit cards, dang it. Yeah.
So Chris, you're going to have to turn on two-factor as well in your account. So we can do that together or, you know, at some point, or you can try to do it yourself. It's not too bad.
Yeah, I think me and my wife could get through that pretty easy. You tell me when I need to do it, we'll get it done.
Okay, great. Let's put in your tax ID number just to really make this account legit and
okay.
Yeah.
Give me one second here and I'll, babe, we really need you in here for this process on a lot of this. There's a lot of this that you know that I don't. He needs the EIN number.
And last thing, Jennifer, I'm going to be adding an email address in here for you. What's the email address you use, you personally use for the business?
Jennifer@rainstormsolutionsllc.com.
Does that look right?
Yes.
Okay. Are you able to open up that email on this computer right now?
I am.
How do I do that? Oh, you're going to do it. Perfect.
I'm sorry.
No, you're great. This is fantastic. Usually I have to over explain things, but you seem to know how to do everything, and that's amazing. Perfect.
Before I could get her to come to work for me, she worked for guys who owned retirement mobile home parks, 17
oh, yeah?
of them. Yeah, she was the general manager and the go-to for all of that. So I got lucky.
Yeah, it's, you really are lucky. It's amazing to have someone that knows how all this stuff works, because this is actually such, like, it could just turn your brain into a pretzel if you don't know how to do it.
It's mind-numbing.
It truly is. That's a better way to put it. All right. So you
are good to go?
Yeah, you're perfect. I don't think okay. I need anything else from you at the moment. This is great. If I were to reload this page, which I'll do right now, it should say that this has been verified. Yeah, it has. Great. So that's fantastic. All right. So now that we've set up your business manager, for the most part, you know, there's some things we're going to do when we build out your account, like create custom conversions and other things like that. But right now, your business manager is like rock solid. You have an admin in the way of Jennifer, who's got full access to this, you know, two-factor authentication turned on. It's your account secure. Now I'm going to add in both myself and my assistant so that we can, you know, do what we do without having to get you on a Zoom call every time, because that would be crazy. Cool. So I'll add both of us in here like that. And then I'll give us the access, you know, the full access that we need in order to do everything. Manage. And I'm going to make sure that we're able to, you know, it like if one of your cards goes bad or something and you don't feel like logging in here to enter it yourself, we'll be able to, you know, if you send us like a text message or a message in our a project manager software of a picture of the front and back of the card that you want to use, we can always just help you by adding it in for you. So that's good.
Yeah, no worries. And believe it or not, we've had those cases happen and they turned off one card and sent us another and we had to go back and give everybody the darn numbers. So
yeah, it happens. Yeah,
it so does. Yeah.
Manage pixels. So I do want to also make sure we have your Instagram account connected here. So we might need Jennifer in order to get the Instagram account login information. So it's looking for the login info for Instagram. So it's going to ask us for the username. And maybe it's saving.
Hey, babe. Username and password for the Instagram.
Oh.
I think you deleted some of the letters there.
I did on accident. Uh-oh.
That's all right.
Log in. There we go. I don't think that's it. It's phone number or email. It could be your... There we go.
Let's see if that works.
To take you to...
It's just Brian confirming your appointment, honey.
Perfect.
All good right. to go.
Good to go.
Set up your two step.
Yeah, done he here. Said he could do it for me, but I don't know if you have a problem doing it. So, I mean, you could go authenticate that.
Your pair of appointments at 11:30.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So we're just adding in all of this control here.
Perfect.
That's weird. Oh, I know why. Oops, that's not the right thing. So I need to accept that invite before I can add.
Gotcha.
Let's see if I can figure this out on my end. So I'm using my computer right now. I'm just accepting this invite. See if it works now. Yeah, now I'm there. Okay. All right. So lesson learned there. Accept the invite before adding yourself into certain assets that don't take. So
right.
Yeah. So, all right. So I've got the access we need. Your business manager is in perfect shape right now. You have an ad account with a payment card on it. I'm going to stop sharing your screen.